Hello, Paul Ellis from the RIC Group here. Going to give you a webinar on our supply chain solution for Sage 300. The RIC Group was established in 2001. We have customers all over Australia and New Zealand, North America, Asia, Middle East and Africa. The majority of our customers are in distribution and manufacturing. We've been a sponsor for the Sage 300 roadshows. We're a current Sage 300 development partner and we work with the Sage 300 partner channel globally. Why TB04 from the RIC Group? Firstly, our warehouse management solution is a proven warehouse management solution and it's written in new technology, so it will run on all environments and is completely agnostic to operating system. Our audits are in real time and you can use Power BI for business intelligence, reports and KPI reports. Works with Sage 300 through the web service and uses the API for integration. You can use Android rugged devices for barcode scanning or tablet devices mounted in forklifts for a barcode scanning as well. The RIC Group software is Australian made and Australian owned, and we have several freight integration with a number of carriers. You can email us at sales@thericgroup.com for further information, visit our website or visit our YouTube site. So I'm going to give you a webinar on the goods receiving process against a purchase order. So what I have done here is created a purchase order in Sage 300, and we can see it's purchase order number 71 against industrial batteries. Using the warehouse management solution, I can go into the goods receipt and say receiving. Straight away, I'm going to have a look and I can see filter by supplier. So I can filter by all suppliers and say all, or I can filter by the actual supplier I want. And we can see straight away here that 71 is here. So I have my two products. And I can scan my barcodes of these products and the received quantity will increment. Remember that because it's a real-time WMS with multi-users, I could have multiple people receive these products at the same time. It's a really important aspect to note that there could be multiple users all using the WMS at once and could be all using the goods receipt at once. There's no limit of users. So by clicking in this item here, I can now start doing my receive process. But just to show you as well, like if it runs on multiple devices, I can say developer tools here, and you can see here I can just use different items. Doesn't matter which one it is. And it automatically resizes to what it's running on, which operating system and which device. So I'm going to receive two here. Obviously, if I was barcode scanning them, it will increment the receive quantity. And if I had inner and outers, so I could use inner barcode and outer barcode, select my item here. Once I've received the two items, the process is then to put away. So I need to put away in the bin locations. So this is a multi-bin solution for Sage 300. I could have different bin locations with different quantities. When I go to the put away, it's going to give me the actual document that's open for the receipt. So I can click into here. So this is a really important aspect to note as well, that as soon as I've received a quantity, I can put away a quantity. So I could have people working on the goods receipt area and then people working in the put away area simultaneously at the same time. And what I have received, I can then put away. So by clicking into the item, I could barcode scan and increment the quantity. I'm going to say two. So I've got my item, and once I click add the two, we can save the two here, no problems at all. So I've put the item away in this bin location, 1AA11. If I go back, I can then go and put this item away, the desk lights. So I could choose a different bin location, I could scan a different bin location, doesn't matter. So what I've got here is I've received an amount and then I've put away amount. I could have an enable put away, so a put away all, so we have a put away all function. Once I have put the items away, I can go back and I can now click on complete because the quantity received equals the quantity put away. So this is now going to go back into Sage 300, update the purchase order and create a goods receipt. Just before I do that, I just want to show you that there is a receiving and put away audit. So what I've been doing in the goods receipt area and the put away area are up to date in real time, and management can have a look at what's going on in the audit. So you can see straight away, I've got my items here that I've received, and I can also do the put away audit. So I can see the items that have been put away and in which bin location by which user. So let's go into say 300. You can see 71. We can see now the receipt 116. So the goods receipt has been created. And if I open up the receipt in Sage 300, I can then see 116 relates to purchase order 71. I've got my items in the location, I've got my quantity received, and it's all come across through from the warehouse management solution. I can then go on and do my normal processes from there. So one of the other things we can do is also stop transfers. So if I go into the transactions and go into transfers, so if I was transferring stock from one warehouse to another, I could use the warehouse management solution to do that. So let's quickly go into inventory and do a stock transfer. I'm just going to create a new stock transfer. And I'm just going to do a manual input. But note here that I could scan bin locations from, and then scan the product and scan the bin location to, and transfer that. I could use the pick all from the bin. So transferring an item from the bulk, I could then transfer that by using the pick all to the pick face if I was doing a replenishment. And then I can use a put all function as well. So here we've got the ability to search for a bin location manually. And I can choose a bin location. And what I'm going to do is then search for and see, I can select an item, and what I want to do is transfer. So if I select transfer, you can say it's going to enter a two bin or a two warehouse. So what I want to do is then select another warehouse. And I know that there's a system bin in the warehouse 3 and a system bin in warehouse 1, and say confirm, say transfer, and I can see down here that it's entered in the data correctly. I then confirm. Remember that it's a very organic warehouse management solution with Sage 300, so the data is all actually in Sage 300, so all the items, the batches, the batch numbers, the serial numbers, all is actually sitting in Sage 300. So if I go back to the Sage 300, there should be another transfer, 31, and we can see Halogen Desk Light has come through, and we've requested quantity 2, and it's gone from, you know, location 1 to location 3. Note that the multi-bin locations are actually sitting in the warehouse management solution. There is another function called Stock Lookup. Stock Lookup gives us the ability to quickly look up an item, see what quantity it is, obviously by barcode scanning it, and I can quickly see how much of a quantity is in a bin location and in another warehouse. So we can see the different warehouse codes. I can quickly see that this item has 410 in system bin and 2 in the AA11, which is the bin locations we just put away the items in. Thank you for listening. Feel free to email us at sales@therickgroup.com for further information. Appreciate your time. Thank you.